So hello friends, so welcome back to this channel again. So today we are going to learn what is the inverse Laplace transformation. Okay, what is the inverse Laplace transformation? Generally, if function is given f of t, after Laplace transformation that converted into f of s. So the function is the f of t is the IC, the Laplace transformation collapse. So f of s will convert. But here what exactly we are doing is inverse Laplace transformation means what? F of t h t, तबु inverse Laplace transformation करा। जो f of s थिला, तबु transform करेगी तबु कौनो? F of t दे convert करा हो। ऐसे m t convert करा हो। F of s थिले तबु Laplace inverse Laplace transformation करेगी। And this is the notation for inverse Laplace transformation है ना? Inverse Laplace transformation notation कौनो? L रो power हो ची minus one। Okay? Then I am going to solve some examples so that you can understand completely. Okay? So here Laplace transformation of cos 2t. The Laplace transformation कौन थी Formula कौन? कौन थी formula? Cos a t का formula कौन थी S by s square plus a square. But here a is equal कौन? 2. So it is s by s square plus 2 square is equal to 4. Okay, this is the Laplace transformation. So cos 2t is equal to inverse Laplace transformation of s by s square plus 4. Right? So s by s square plus 4 ro inverse Laplace transformation is cos 2t. Bujhi parlo? Bujhi parlo nahi? So emiti ame kon kariya solve kariya. Our example kono?
Here one one thing is Laplace transformation of so the f1t is equal to Laplace transformation of f2t. Right? So that is equal, then we can say that f1 of t is equal to f2 of t. Okay, you remember this one. These are some of the formulas that you need to remember exactly. Okay, Laplace transformation of 1 by s is equal to 1. Laplace transformation of 1 by s plus a is equal to e to the power minus a t. Okay? See, because Laplace transformation of e to the power a t is what? E to the power a is equal to 1 by s minus a. But here a is what? Minus of minus a. That's why minus minus plus. That's why e to the power minus a t. Similarly, you need to remember all these formulas. Okay? This formula. You need to remember these formulas. Earlier we have studied everything. Only what we are doing here is inverse Laplace transformation. Nothing else. So these are the some formulas that you need to remember exactly. Okay. So now we can go for suppose a function is given in terms of fraction. Fraction means in terms of some p by q format. Okay. Px into qx format. Then we can use the partial fraction method to make inverse Laplace transformation of this one. So how it is going to be, you can see here. Suppose p of s and q of s is given. Okay, p of s is from a naught into s to the power m plus a1 into s to the power m minus 1 plus dot 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 plus a to the power m divided by b naught into s to the power n plus b1 into s to the power n minus 1 plus dot 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 plus b to the power n. Okay, if this is given and m and n, here m and n, these are positive integers. Okay, integers. Then we can use the partial fraction method. How to do the partial fraction? I'm going to give one example so that you can understand completely. Okay, suppose sq minus 4s plus 5 is given. This is a numerator, means log of, and s square minus 3s plus 2 is given. This is a horror. So we are asked to find the inverse Laplace transformation of this function. So here you can see that the upper the upper polynomial, it has a degree 3, and the lower polynomial, it has a degree 2. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide the numerator by denominator. So you can see here x square minus 3s plus 2, I'm going to divide, right, s cube minus 4s plus 5. Okay, so here if I'm going to write s, then s into s square will be s cube, s minus, this will be minus 3s square plus 2s. Okay, now it is subtraction, so it is going to be plus, and this one is going to be minus. So here s square going to be cancel out each other, so the answer will be here 0, and but here it is s square, but here it is minus 4s, that's why. But here it is plus term, this is plus term, so this is going to be plus 3s square minus 4s minus 2s minus 6s plus minus 6s plus 5 is going to be coming down, it's going to come down. Okay, now what exactly I'm going to put so that things will be looks pretty? So here if I'm going to put just 4s, right, okay, if I'm going to put my plus 3, then 3s square minus 9s plus 6. Now you subtract, this is going to be plus, this is going to be minus, so here answer will be minus, sorry, plus 3s plus minus 1, 3s minus 1 is the what remainder, and this is a quotient and this is a divisor. So this this you can write s square minus 4s plus 5 divided by s square minus 3s plus 2, that you can write what this quotient s plus 3 into, sorry, plus 3s minus 1 divided by s square minus 3s plus 2. This one also in a mixed fraction we can write like this. So example, if I'm going to write 4 by 3, how we are going to make it mixed fraction? This is a what, or natural improper, this is improper fraction because the numerator is bigger than the denominator, that's why 3 ones are 3 plus 1 by 3. We can write 4 by 3 is equal to 1 plus 1 by 3, right? 3 ones are 3 plus 1, 4 by 3. We can write. Similarly, 10 by 3. How you can write 3 3s are 10 plus 1 by 3. We can write. Exactly, I have converted this what fraction into this format. Now apply the Laplace transformation both sides. Okay. Apply the Laplace transformation for both sides, and we can see that how things are going to convert it. Okay, I hope that you have understood this one. Okay, so I am going to solve some examples so that you can understand completely. Example